Running a family business is like working 24 hours a day. There's no rest time, because even when you're at home, your family members will be talking to you about problems that they encounter and how to deal with certain things. My name is Yuling. I'm a third generation Indonesian Chinese. I've been running the Tambuah Mas restaurants for more than 10 years. Tambuah Mas is a family-run restaurant for over 40 years. We are one of the oldest traditional Indonesian restaurants in Singapore. We emphasize on our home-style cooking to bring the freshest and the most authentic Indonesian dishes to your table. There's no shortcuts because we believe that shortcuts is not the way to go for traditional style of cooking. My dad was actually doing trading. He had a lot of dealings with Indonesians. When they come to Singapore, they want something to eat. There were not many Indonesian restaurants back then. So he decided to open up his own restaurant, and they call it Tambuah Mas. When we are talking about Indonesian food, we actually have to look at the country itself. Indonesia is made up of 17,000 of islands with 5 major ones. Basically, you have dishes with similar name from different regions, but basically the taste itself is different. For example, Japanese food is a bit more sweeter, whereas Padang food is spicier. Food is very important in Indonesian culture because it brings the family together. Example, you have family members working in paddy fields, and then when it comes to dinner or lunchtime, they all will come back home and share their food amongst their family members. Most dishes actually are good for communal dining. The Indonesian food that we serve here are from different parts of Indonesia. We have recipes from Sulawesi, Padang and Java. Tau telur is our signature dish. It's actually a must-have for every diner who comes in. So how this tau telur came out about, it's because my auntie was experimenting tau telur in the kitchen. She came out with this fluffy version that is now actually a hit at our restaurant. If you actually ask Indonesians, to them tau telur is actually a tofu omelette. It's nothing like this. So we actually do have Indonesians flying in and coming to our restaurants to ask for the fluffy version of the tau telur. When I first took over, I was actually quite lost with how to manage a restaurant. It's actually very challenging and very difficult because there's many expectations. Sometimes it's not really what you think you want to do, but more of what is expected of you. But the good thing was my parents could still give me some support and some advice. When I first joined the business, fusion food was something very big. So everybody was trying to do fusion food, and then I was looking back at our own menu and I told my dad, hey, you know, I think we need to make some change because, you know, we are selling like authentic traditional food and then everybody's into fusion food these days. So I think we need to make some changes, if not we will lose out in the market. But he was very sharp, like, as all businessmen are. He actually told me that no, just stick to what we are doing best and just keep to it. I'm actually glad that I actually listened to him. And because if I had my own way back then, I don't think we'll be here now today. I think with every second or third generation owners, they are worried about not being able to carry on the business or to have the business feel in their hands. To be honest, that is always something that worries me sometimes. But of course, I believe with the knowledge that they have imparted to me and the guidance that I've received from them, I can definitely do my best, continue running this. Indonesian food has a very long history. We believe in serving only authentic Indonesian food, and that is why we have stuck to the same recipe for many, many years. We also want the next generation to know how authentic Indonesian food should taste like.